In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students of Class Center. I hope you have understood the previous lectures, and you will also you have also gained from these lectures. And today's lecture is on the second lesson from the text Reflection on the Reawakening of Ease. My dear students, Reflection on the Reawakening of East. It means it is written by the Bertrand Russell. So because the Bertrand Russell has given focus on the East and West. So East, it means Asian countries. His views, his opinions regarding the Asian countries, because the Western countries they have focused upon the industrialization and have dominated over the other nation as well. So we will learn about the reflection on the reawakening of East. Reawakening, as we know about the awake, it means to inspire the Eastern countries, like Asian countries. So in China, as you know that China has developed in the Asian from the Asian countries in the world. So here I would also give the brief description about the reflection of the reawakening of East and its writer Bertrand Russell. So now, Reflection on the Reawakening of East is an essay delivered by the Bertrand Russell. He was one of the most outstanding writer and thinker. He wrote many books on philosophy and mathematics. However, his notable work for their introduction of scientific attitude and discussion of politics. Scientific attitude and discussion about the politics. Why the Bertrand Russell has used the scientific attitude? Scientific attitude, it means the experiment in the science, and is should be developing itself toward the science, and use of politics, and it should not be dominated over other like the Western countries have used. I would also tell you in this lesson that he also share the knowledge about the history. It means the power shuffle or transfer from West to East and East to West. It means that when there was the power to the Western countries, and it shuffled or it transferred to the Eastern countries due to the barbarism of the Western countries. Barbarism, it means they were lack of confidence, they were lack of using power in the Western countries. That's why the power transferred to the Eastern countries. So now proceed here, I would like to reawakening of East. It is an important phenomenon in the history of civilization of the modern world. As in Bertrand Russell is also give the opinion about the East should be move forward, and it should not be stick into the war. Definitely one nation who is stick into the war, and definitely it will be destroyed. He inspired the Eastern countries like Pakistan, India, and which country did, or in Asian countries, to focus upon the industrialization and move forward and avoid the dominating in on the other nation like the Western country had adopted to dominate over the Eastern countries or other nations as well. Nation of the power between the West and East, East to West. Okay, so because in the history the power of the world was in the hand of the Western countries, whenever it shuffled, it transferred to Eastern countries due to the barbarism of the in knowledge, information, in scientific work. After that, the whenever the power transferred to Eastern countries, means Asian countries, they also learn why the power transferred due to their barbarism, due to their lack of interest as well. So here Bertrand Russell focus upon the East must be industrialized, but these industrial technologies and scientific devices when applied to war are really horrible. Bertrand Russell also aware the Eastern country that they must be focused upon the industrialization and scientific work, but these industrialization or power or scientific work must not be used for war or to keep the other nation dominated. So here the Bertrand Russell is also in favor of democracy. Democracy, it means people should be given the equal rights, okay, and they should be entertained, or they should be choose their leader, and the leader must be represent his people as well. So here scientific device applied for warrior war. The Asian people must not follow the West in order to be strong and dominating. Here why the Bertrand Russell has given the point that the Asian people must not follow the West in order to be strong and dominating. Because the Western country who adopted the power and they used the power on the Eastern countries or other nations who were underdeveloped. At the end, Bertrand Russell repeated that the East must devote its energy and skill toward peace, not toward the exploitation of those who are less qualified in expertise and resources. It means the East should be a step forward for peace, not for war or fight. Okay, so these were my dear students the point, the reflection of the reawakening of East. What was the reflection of the reawakening of East? The reflection of the reawakening means the Bertrand Russell wished to reawakening East because they should stay forward and become industrialization and become developed rather than to adopt the domination on the other. As you know that he also expressed his concern regarding, he also favored the democracy. So okay, and he also said the world is temporary as well in a religious point of view, because everyone has come to work and serve or pray. Okay, and after that he will be definitely die as well. So my dear student, this is the brief description about the Bertrand Russell and the reflection of the reawakening of East, because it is the essay that was given by the Bertrand Russell. So now come to the exercise here. So here answer this question below. Very briefly, answer may be given to question 9 to 10. Why is it insular for European history to trump the centuries after the fall of Roman Empire, the Dark Ages? I clarify here that the when Roman Empire lost their power, okay, to the East, they went into the barbarism, and they feel that they have in a Dark Ages. They consider their time that we are in a dark ages because they have lost their power to the Eastern countries as well. On what ground does the author argue that communism is the most modern and virulent? Virulent means cruel form of Western imperialism. Imperialism means domination. Communism is jo the communist countries like Russian communist that whose main purpose is to bring the nations in a one demagogue, in it means a one leadership to rule over them. Because in this what ground the author argued that communism is the most modern world, because the if the communism will be use it, or if the nation are under the flag of communism, they will not be entertained, they will be not independent to use their life in the peace. To what cause does the author attribute the power of England in the early 19th century and the power of the United States and Russian today? So, as you noted in earlier, there were the two blocks, Russia, USSR in other words, and United States, they also called the nation to join their bloc as well. It was the created to cause to rise the knowledge of Western knowledge in the countries. Like this, Russian and United States, they were calling the nation and they to join their blocs. Number fourth, why does the author consider useless to resist industrialization? Resist, okay? So, in this, the author considered it is useless to resist industrialization because whenever these nations followed or manufactured the industrialization, they dominated to other. If they joined the industrialization to development, they also use the power on the other nation as well. My dear student, number five, does the author welcome cultural uniformity or not? So we are asked that is their writer uses the cultural uniformity or not? How does he justifies attitude? Because in this, the author is against the cultural uniformity. Because if a Western, the development of nation, uniformity, it means that the culture don't allow the nation to the development. The writer's opinion is that it is culture that fetter or strain the development of the nation as well. Number six, how is traditional culture treated in the age dominated by science? The traditional culture is treated in the age of dominated by science because anyone of the bigger powers might secure domination over small nations. And this means how is the traditional culture treated in age of dominated? Because the bigger nations dominated over the smaller nation. As you know that the one is dominated, it means smaller nation cannot progress or develop. And the dominant nation, whatever say the smaller nation or who are under dominated, they will do according to dominated. Number seven, what reason does the author give for this opinion that the nation of Asia will not find how to keep their independence? So here, give opinion that the nation of Asia will not find it hard to keep their independence. So because in this question, the writer opined that if the nation who will join the two blocks, Russian and United States, definitely they will be follow according to these rule. And it will not be fair for them to make progress. So here, my dear students, in number 8, what is in author's view has been the most serious flaw in the character of the West over the last few centuries? The serious flaw, it means a blunder, mistake in the character of the West, means Western countries over the last few centuries, that they, the Western countries keep dominated to other countries, okay? Because they wanted to domination on the others. Number 9, what parallel may be drawn between the decline of the power of Europe at the end of Roman Empire and the decline in the power of Europe in 1940? So, my dear student, the decline of power of Roman Empire followed by militant Muslim Empire. Okay, so as I told you that the Europeans' powers, even Western power, transferred to the Eastern countries. Number 10, what is in the author's opinion should Asian country accept from West and what should they reject? So here is very simple. Then the Asian country should not accept the power or sense of the domination of the other. And they should follow toward peace. So because my dear student, it was the lesson you also knew about the reawakening of East, and you we also done the exercise. I think you have covered the main purpose of the lesson. So at the end I will assign you use this lesson in your own words, okay, in your own opinion, and define it what was the writer's purpose to deliver or give the write the essay on these points. And keep in your mind, in next lecture we will practice upon the precis writing, okay, because your textbook is mostly about the writing skill. It means it's based upon the writing power, and there is a precis writing is mostly in second textbook. The precis writing, that is the most important. Essay writing and precis writing, that is used in the competitive examination as well. Okay, my dear students, so your assignment, your homework will be to define the lesson in your own words, and it's also techniques of the writers, what writer define and what writer forward from these points. Thank you, my dear students.